Hey, what's up? It's another week, and today I got to put a window or an opening into the old chicken coop. That way they get some more light because it's winter time. The egg production slowed down, so I got to get them some more natural light, and that should help with egg production. And it's just the old chicken coop, so let's go over there and mess with it real quick. And I've got plans for a new coop that's gonna house all of them, so let's go check this out. All right, good morning everybody. Yep, come on out. These are all the mostly bannies in this cage. Some of the big ones like to be in there, I don't know why. But here's the big birds. Come on out, ladies. And there's Johnny. Johnny, that's Junior. Johnny was an old rooster, but that's Junior right there. Hello, buddy. Big boy. How about some corn for y'all? Some scratch. All right, so you see the two coops right here. This blue one, that's a newer one. We put that together a few years ago and did some improvements to it. And that's where the bannies are and a few of those other bigger hens. This coop right here behind me, the brown one, that thing, it's temporary, but it's 20 years old temporary. I built that when we moved to the property so I could put the birds in it right away. It was kind of it was temporary because I knew I was gonna build a new one. I just never got around to it because, you know, life takes over. And this thing's been scabbed together by just a bunch of lumber that I had left over at the old place. And, you know, it's got some paint on it, and that helped it. You can see there, right in the corner there of the roof, a tree limb fell on that, and it cracked and busted that up. But it's not leaking inside. It's still dry inside. But I need, I never put windows in this thing. There is a door, a little door on the bottom. You can see where the chickens come out inside that fence. Usually I just open the door and they get all the light. But I want them to be, you know, to wake up with natural light. And then the light that I have inside, it comes on later in the day. That way it extends their day into the evening. And it helps for better egg production. So what I'm going to do is cut a hole somewhere in the front. Let me switch hands. Somewhere in the front, probably over there on the far side. I'll cut a hole. I'm gonna put some screen mesh in there, and that way that also, it faces east, so when the sun comes up, they're gonna get the sun in there. The roost is not on that side, so that's good. The roost is over on the other side here, and so when the natural light comes up, it'll wake them up. And it'll provide more natural light for them, and it's always good. So it's time to do this. It's been forever. Let's get it done. All right, so like I was saying earlier, I'm gonna put the screen, the window, the opening right here behind me in this panel. This is where it's gonna go, right there. And I'm gonna make it the stud work that I have in there is like every 2 feet. It's whatever scrap I had left over is what I did. And what I'm gonna do is put this screen, just some regular old chicken screen that I have laying around. I'm gonna have to cut it down a little bit because it's a little too big. I'll mark it out with my with the drill, the holes from the inside. So I'll drive this through first, and then I'm going to just use a circular saw to cut my lines out. And I'm gonna overcut this because I'm gonna just put it on the face, and I'll tack it up with some screws, or maybe maybe my staple gun. And then these are just some pieces that I have that were in the barn that I want to make it look kind of used, so I'm not using brand new stuff. So this is stuff that I had from some other wooden project, and this might look good as a frame on the outside. Who knows? Maybe I'll paint it. Probably not. But anyway, I got to get some of these nails out. This one's a little more decorative. It came from a pallet, so I might use this across the top. It all depends what I have left over after it's cut. So first things first, I got to get in there and cut the four holes out, measure that, and cut the hole out. Let there be light. the birds don't like all this noise, especially when there's tall things. If I carry like a shovel around or these tall things right here, if I'm carrying them up above my head, they hate it. They just take off running. I don't know what it is. They must think it's a threat, like the hawks are. Somewhere. That is my high point, so I'm gonna go a bit lower than that and I'll cut that right out. Looks like 24 by 24 is gonna work out just right. And that is going to give them some much needed light. Depending on when I get the start working on the new coop, it's going to replace this one. I might throw another small window on somewhere in here. I just don't want to set them up for an issue or you know, a situation where they're going to get the cold air on them, the wind. We don't want that. Right here where this one is, their roosts are far away from that hole. The roosts are all along here. So we'll see how this does. If this helps out with their light situation inside, it'll be good. If not, I might have to throw another one. I might maybe up high on the other side. I just don't want the wind to come through and hit them in the winter time because that cold wind is not good for them. So let's start cutting this mesh and installing it. So I'm just gonna put it up temporarily with this to hold it in place, and then the screws that I screw the trim boards on will finish it off. I need two of these. So since it's just rough carpentry stuff here, I'm just going to trace the side of that and cut this side of the line so we're about the same. Ah, perfect. Okay, so these two right here will be the sides. Let's get these screws out of here. All right, I'm gonna get this one in place now. Okay. Let's go 27 and a half on this. 27 and a half, and that'll take me edge to edge on the from left to right on the trim pieces. So 27 and a half, here we go. You know, a lot of strange things going on with sports. A lot of people, suddenly things are happening to them. Huh. Wonder what that's all about. Alright, now I just gotta cut the top piece up. A little tiny nail head sticking out here. Oh, the point, a screw, it's a screw point. Now see, when you're doing something like this, you don't necessarily need, of course this is just rough carpentry, and I'm not a carpenter, I just know how to get things done, but you don't have to pull measurements all the time. You can just work off one point, as long as you're level, square, or looks good to the eye, especially on this thing, because none of this is level or square because it's on a hill, and over the years it's kind of moved a little bit and dropped. It's still only sitting on blocks, see? But when it's up, do the eye test. Give it the eye test and see what it looks like. If you like it, then you're in. All right, let's cut this and then pull those nails and put it up. All right, another pro tip, dangerous pro tip. Put a screw in it ahead of time, like before you get up there. That way you don't have to mess around with trying to start a screw up there where you can't reach it. Get it started down here. I'm gonna do three. It doesn't take much, need much. Let's see. How's it look from over there? Looked like it's been there forever.
Yeah, I like it.
All right, that's good. Well, that's it. Pretty good looking window. It doesn't look bad there. Get this thing out of the way here. Didn't need this after all. Had enough of that other scrap left over, but it's not a bad looking window, is it? Looks pretty good, I think. Kind of fits the old school dirty barn chicken coop looking thing. So this will work for now. And that's safe. There's not the animals of, you know, the coons and stuff never been, that's pretty high off the ground. They never been messing around over there. They usually just go in sometimes to get the food through their little door inside the coop there. If I leave it out, forget about it, but it's never really been an issue. I like it. It looks good. So I'm going to leave it that way and we'll check and see if the egg production increases a little bit, like I think it will. I just want to get busy on this next chicken coop, and I think you guys are really going to like it. It looks, the plan so far look really good. I know I'm not going to put it here in this spot. This is all a slope where this is at, up along the edge of the woods over here, and I don't want to put it back on a slope if I don't have to. Maybe I'll pick another place on the property to put it, something that's a little more flat, but we'll see. We'll see how it goes. I can make it movable, so I can just pick it up with the loader, you know, with the forks underneath, and do it that way. If I have to, but that's it. Getting stuff done here on the homestead. Making these chickens happy. We'll talk to you soon, and remember, stay dangerous.